Now here the question is, tangents are drawn to hyperbola 4x square minus y square equals 36 at the points P and Q. If the tangents intersect at the point T, which is 0,3, find the area of triangle PTQ. Now, once we know this point, we can find equation of chord of contact. So, equation of chord of contact is given by T equals 0. So, in this case, this equation will be 3y equals 36, that is value of y is minus 12. Now we'll find these points P and Q, which is point of intersection of this chord of contact and hyperbola. So we'll put the value of y as minus 12. So we'll put y as minus 12, we'll get 4x square minus 144 equals 36. So it'll be 4x square equals 180. Value of x square will be 45, that is value of x is plus or minus 3 root 5. Now we can write coordinates of P and Q. So P and Q, they'll be given by 3 root 5 minus 12. Q will be minus 3 root 5 minus 12. And then this T is 0,3. Now we need to find area of this triangle. This point is 0,3. This is minus 3 root 5 minus 12. And here it is 3 root 5 and 12. Now, what is the length of the base? Length of the base is 6 root 5. And height is 15. So, area of this triangle will be 1 by 2. 6 root 5 into 15. And there will be 45 root 5 square units, and that's your option number A. Now here the question is, if tangents to parabola y square equals 4ax intersect the hyperbola at A and B, then locus of point of intersection of tangents at A and B is parabola y square equals kx. We need to find the value of k. Now we have a parabola which is y square equals 4ax. Say this is y square equals 4ax, and suppose tangent to this parabola, it intersects this hyperbola at two points A and B. Now first we need to find locus of point of intersection of tangents at A and B. So let this point be alpha comma beta. So if this point is alpha comma beta, we can write equation of this chord of contact. Equation of chord of contact AB is given by T equals 0. So this equation will be alpha x upon a square minus beta y upon b square, it is equal to 1. Now this chord of contact, it must be a tangent to this parabola. So we can rewrite this equation as beta y upon b square, and it is equal to alpha x upon a square minus 1. And we'll write this as y equals alpha b square upon beta a square x minus b square upon beta. Now this is m and that's your c. Now condition of tangency for parabola is c equals a by m. Now c in this case is minus b square upon beta, a is simply a, and what is the value of m? M is alpha b square upon beta a square. So we can write this equation as a cube beta square, and it'll be equal to minus b to the power 4 alpha. So this locus will be y square equals minus b to the power 4 upon a cube x. So the value of k must be minus b4 upon a cube, and that's your option B. Now here the question is, let h equals x square minus y square equals 9. P is this parabola which is y square equals 4x minus 5. And this line L is x equals 9. Now it says, if L is the chord of contact of hyperbola h, then equation of corresponding pair of tangents is. Now we know that for this hyperbola, which is x square minus y square equals to 9, let the point from which tangents is drawn be P, and which is say alpha comma beta, then equation of chord of contact is given by t equals 0, which is alpha x minus beta y, and it is equal to 9. Now it is given that this chord of contact is L, which is x equals 9, which simply means value of alpha is 1 and beta is 0. So tangents, they are drawn from the point 1 comma 0. Now we need to find equation of corresponding pair of tangents. So we know that equation of pair of tangents is given by SS1 equals T square. Now S is equation of this hyperbola, which is x square minus y square minus 9. What is the value of S1? Now we'll put x as 1 and y as 0. We'll get this value as minus 8 and then T square. What's T? T in this case is x minus 9. So it'll be x minus 9 whole square. So we'll get this equation as minus 8x square plus 8y square plus 72, and it'll be equal to x square plus 81 minus 18x. So we can write this equation as 9x square minus 8y square minus 18x plus 9 equals 0, and that's your option number B. Now second part is, if R is point of intersection of tangents to H at the extremities of chord L, then equation of chord of contact of R with respect to parabola is. Now this point R is 1 comma 0. Now we need to find equation of chord of contact with respect to this parabola. Now again, for this parabola, equation of chord of contact is given by T equals 0. So we can write this equation as 0y and then 4. In place of x, we'll write x plus 1 by 2 minus 5. So we'll get 0 equals x plus 1 minus 10. So this equation will be x equals 9, which again is this line L. Now this third part is, if the chord of contact of R with respect to parabola P meets the parabola at T and T dash. That means this line L, it meets this parabola at T and T dash. So we'll put x as 9. So we'll put x as 9, we'll get y square equals 4. And then 9 minus 5 is 4. So value of y will be plus or minus 4. So these points T and T dash, they'll be say 9 comma 4 and 9 comma minus 4. And S is the focus of parabola. So we know that focus of parabola is a comma 0. So capital X is A and capital Y is 0. Now X in this case is X minus 5. And A is 1 and Y is simply Y. So focus is at 6 comma 0. So S is at 6 comma 0. We need to find area of this triangle STT dash. So we have 3 points, S which is at 6 comma 0, T which is at 9 comma 4, and T dash which is at 9 comma minus 4. Now what is height? Height is 3 and base is 8. So area of this triangle will be half base into height, which is simply 12 square unit, and that's your option number C. Now here the question is, tangents are drawn from any point on hyperbola to this circle. Now it says the locus of midpoint of chord of contact is a x square plus y square whole square equals b x square plus c y square. If a square plus b square plus c square is equal to k, we need to find last digit in k. Now for this hyperbola, we can take any point P as 3 secant theta and 2 10 theta. Now from this point, pair of tangents are drawn to this circle, then equation of chord of contact is given by T equals 0. So this equation will be 3x secant theta plus 2y 10 theta, and it is equal to 1. Now we need to find locus of midpoint of this chord of contact. So let the midpoint be M, and which is say alpha comma beta. Now if we know midpoint of a chord, we can write its equation as T equals S1. So for this circle, equation of chord with given midpoint will be T, which is alpha x plus beta y minus 1, and it will be equal to alpha square plus beta square minus 1. So this equation will be alpha x plus beta y, and it is alpha square plus beta square. Now these two equations, they represent the same line. So we can write 3 secant theta upon alpha equals 2 tan theta upon beta, and it is equal to 1 upon alpha square plus beta square. So from here we can write secant theta as alpha upon 3 alpha square plus beta square, and tan theta is beta upon 2 alpha square plus beta square. Now in order to find this locus, we'll need to eliminate theta. So we know that secant square theta minus tan square theta is 1. So we can write alpha square upon 9 alpha square plus beta square whole square minus beta square upon 4 alpha square plus beta square whole square, it is equal to 1. So we can write this locus as 4x square minus 9y square, and it will be equal to 36 x square plus y square whole square. We'll get value of a as 36, value of b as 4, and value of c as 9. So the value of k will be a square, which is 36 square plus 4 square plus 9 square. Now we need not find the value of k, we just need to find last digit in k. Now 36 square will be 6 into 6, 36. So here last digit will be 6. Now 4 square is 16. So last digit for this is 6 again. And then 9 square is 81. So here will be 1. So it will be 6 plus 6 plus 1, and that is 13. So last digit for k will be simply 3. And that is the answer to this question.